My name is Joey Scott, CEO and founder of True Fit Athletic. I'm a strength and conditioning coach of former heavyweight WBC champion Deontay Wilder. So I make sure that he's in shape, you know, get ready for war. I make sure that, you know, he's strong enough, making sure that he's consistent with his power distribution. That's about it. We get it in. When I'm not with Deontay, I'm a three-time Olympic coach, 12-time world championship coach for track and field. I'm also the head coach of the Haitian national team for Tokyo Olympics. And I live here in Miami in the 305 in Dade County, training my Olympic athletes.
So who is your rising star on the track and field?
In general, you have a couple of them. You have Christian Coleman, who just broke the indoor 60-meter world record. You have a guy named Noah Lyles, who actually won world championships recently. So it's a couple of young lions that's coming up in the game to fill the shoes of Usain Bolt. Christian Coleman is actually the guy that got the bronze medal behind Usain Bolt, second place in his last race that he ran when Justin Gatlin won the 100 meters. So we got a couple of rising stars coming up that's young and they hunger for success.
And the ones on your team, rising star on your team?
I have a young lady named Ebony Morrison. She's the American record holder in the 200-meter hurdles. She's a great talent in the 100-meter hurdles. She's ranked in the top 20 in the world. I also have another young lady from British Virgin Islands, Daya Erickson. She's a young upcoming 100-meter hurdler. I have Jeff Jumas, who is a two-time Olympian from the Haitian national team. He's made two Olympic teams. This will be his third one that he made. He's a 110 hurdler. In case you didn't know the name, he's the guy that fell down in 2016 semifinals in the hurdles that went viral, you know. But he's a young lion. He's still coming up. He's still learning. He's going to be great. I got a couple. Ashley Kelly, who's an Olympian as well from British Virgin Islands in the 400 meters. She's somebody to look at. She's a potential medalist as well. We got a couple of people.
So regarding the coronavirus making a threat on the games, what do you think is going to happen?
They canceled World Championship indoors that was in China. Of course, that was supposed to be in China. Actually, this week was supposed to be the World Championships for indoors. For Tokyo, I cannot see them canceling it. But I think it's something that they need to get under control really quick because, just to lose the Olympics, the Olympic Games, in Tokyo, it'll be heartbreaking. You know, it'll be a lot of people affected by it, a lot of countries affected by it. So hopefully they can, quarantine it, get it under control, find out what's going on with it, and where we can still host the games, and where all the countries can come together and just love on each other.
Okay, so we have to get back to Deontay.
Most definitely.
Yeah, so what's going on with the former world champion?
How's
his mindset and the
mindset is strong. His mindset is strong. One of the things that the world needs to understand about Deontay is Deontay was never afraid to lose. Deontay is never afraid to take an L. His idol, that's right up here, that's on one of these pictures, Muhammad Ali, which is his idol, he's lost. You know what I mean? So all the great ones lose. That's how you become one-time champion, two-time champion, three-time champion, four-time champion. Sometimes you got to lose in order to win. So the thing with Deontay, where his mindset at, he don't care about losing. Likes to lose, want to lose, but he know it comes with the territory. Think about it. The world is going crazy. The world is going crazy over one loss. You're undefeated. And you take one loss and the world turns its back on you. I think Steve Cunningham made a great point. He did a Facebook post, which I loved, and it went viral. He said, a lot of people calling him a bum because he lost. And Steve Cunningham said, I wish I was a bum. I wish I was a bum to only take one loss. I wish I was a bum to make the Olympic team within 1 year and get a bronze medal. I wish I was a bum being able to support my whole family, depositing over $30 million in his bank account over one fight. And those are the things. He made a perfectly good point. The things that Deontay have done, the records that he's broke, they just broke a record when he took a loss. That was the most ticket sales in the heavyweight division ever in the history of boxing. He just, it was the most pay-per-view sales, in the history of heavyweight division. You got to understand, when Deontay went to that fight, he was already tied with his idol, Muhammad Ali. People don't talk about those things. And not only that, Deontay, he don't speak for boxing. He speaks for his culture. He speaks for his people. And he's our voice. You know, if I sit here right now and talk about my culture and talk about my people, you know, nobody's going to hear me. But guess what? He's on the biggest stage in the world, and he speaks it, he believe it, and he receive it. You know, and a lot of people, they don't see that, especially his culture. I've never been in a place where you've represented your country, and you've done it with class. You've made history, and you go into your own country, and you get booed. Mm. It's sad. Not only that, you get booed by your own kind. You get booed by your own people. You see what I'm saying? So I think America needs to wake up, because guess what? Every country we've been to with Deontay, they love him. They love him. You know, we'll be going to Africa week after next, and I guarantee they'll show him more love than America have ever showed him. And he represents this country. He speaks for this country. You know what I mean? And I think people need to take notice of that, because it's bigger than boxing for us, especially for our camp. It's bigger than boxing. Boxing, you're going to take some L's. Boxing, you're going to take some W's. You know, but it's how you come back from it. And Deontay, he's a strong-minded person where he's able to come back from it. He's never been afraid to lose, because sometimes you got to lose in order to win.
Yeah, I admire him, because he gave so many guys who have had any opportunity.
Most definitely. Most definitely.
You know, give them back another chance.
Oh, yeah.
To fight him again.
Most definitely.
To redeem themselves.
Most definitely.
You know, I commend him for that. And then, you know, he knew he was going in there with a guy who was hunger, you know, for the belt. You know, all these guys that he's faced.
Right. Most definitely.
Yeah.
The thing is, and another thing, you know, when you're the champion, you have the right to create a road for other fighters. You have an opportunity to create other opportunities for these fighters that don't have opportunity. Let's take Luis Ortiz, for example. We love Luis Ortiz. You know why? Because Luis Ortiz was really grateful for the opportunity that Deontay gave him when Deontay didn't have to give it to him. Luis Ortiz was not Deontay's mandatory. And he still gave him that opportunity to feed his family. And not only that, to take care of that sick daughter of his. You understand? That's the type of fighter Deontay is. If he knows that he can help you out in any kind of way to support your family, he's going to do it. Because, like he always say, these boxers, these fighters, they get in this square circle and they risk everything. They put their life on the line for other people's entertainment. And he respects that. And that's why he respects every fighter. Because not every human being can be able to get in that square circle and risk their life for other people's entertainment, so they can take care of their family and they can actually have, be a voice within the sport. So, you know, I applaud my brother for that, you know. And when he say that he's a king, that's real king movement. See, a lot of people can easily say that they're fighters, right? A lot of people can easily say, I'm undefeated. Right? But what are you doing for the sport, and what are you doing for your culture, and most importantly, what are you doing for your own people? You understand? So that's what he's about.
So you said the rematch would be in July, possibly July?
July, you know, that's what, you know, right now, that's, you know, that's what's on the paper, July. So right now they're in negotiations still. You know, I think the contract is already signed. You know, they already announced it on ESPN, most definitely, but if anything changes, they're in negotiation for their change right now, you know.
Well, Coach, thank you so much for your time.
Blessings to you.
You know, yeah. Blessings. And for, you know, gracing South Florida, you know, loving the 305
area. Yeah, most definitely.
Area.
Most definitely.
Thank you so much.
Hey, and Glenn Johnson is the best.